Teachers have played a huge role in my life. Miss Mincer was my high school drama teacher, Miss Cotton, Miss Elmore, Mr. Holbrook, Mr. White, Miss Williams, who passed away. I feel very lucky that the educators that I had in my life not only influenced me, but the other kids around me to be the best that we could be, to take everything that we could from our moments in school. There was not a teacher that I didn't absolutely love. Not one. Well, my mother was the biggest influence on my life because she taught me how to dream for myself. She placed no limitations on what our dreams could be. And if you could imagine that, failure was never an option because it was always about doing whatever you needed to do to keep your head in the game. And she instilled that in all of us, I think. The best lesson that I've taken from my mom is family first. And I now include my friend family in that. Because if you have a solid foundation, your head will never get too big. You will never lose who you are as a person. So I hold that very, very dear to my heart. To, you know, friends and family first. Of course, with the Lord. The Lord is first, and then friends and family. Growing up with six siblings is like being in a three-ring circus. It is always vying for attention, but it was also wonderful because everyone has someone that they're close to. Everyone has an outlet. Everyone has a pal or friend, and then we're all friendly. One of my fondest memories is my mom trying to teach us to cook, and I'm so squeamish with raw meat, and I like to eat it when it's cooked, but I don't want to see it when it's raw. And she was trying to get me out of that. She made this Brunswick stew, and you have to, you know, boil the chicken and then pull it apart. And I remember putting that chicken there. It was like holding a baby. And for the longest time, I got teased because I was just freaked out about it. So I don't do whole chickens. At any point in my life do I ever deal with whole chickens.